Hi everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about using disk utility on macOS. So here I am on my Mac desktop, and the easiest way to open up disk utility is to use Spotlight. So if I just press Command and Spacebar on my keyboard, you'll notice that it opens up a Spotlight search. Alternatively, I could go to the top right and click on the magnifying glass to search. With Spotlight open, I'm just going to search for disk utility. Notice that it auto-populates, and I could click to open it up. Now, if you do want to know where disk utility is actually located on your system, you can open up a new Finder window, and then just go to your Applications folder. You won't find it directly in the Applications folder, but if you open up the Utilities folder, you'll notice that inside we have disk utility, and we could click to open it up right from here as well. So that's where you can find it if you'd like to open it up manually. Okay, so now let's start talking about what we can do with disk utility. You'll notice that with disk utility open on the left side of my screen, I have a list of drives. So this first one here is the Macintosh HD, and I can click this arrow to the left to drop down any volumes within this volume container. So I can actually create multiple Macintosh hard drives right within this volume. You'll notice that this first one here is grayed out, and that's because this is the system volume. So if you see up here at the top, it says APFS system volume. These are where all my system files are stored. If I were to delete this volume, I might not be able to get back into the computer to use disk utility, and I'd have to use a flash drive or some more invasive method to actually get back on the computer. So we don't really want to do anything with this volume, and that's why it's grayed out. You'll notice it's the system snapshot. Now the second one in the list here is my actual hard drive where all of my data is stored. So I only have one Macintosh installation on this computer. I don't have, you know, two volumes. So this is where all of my data is. So if I was having an issue with my computer, I could come up here to first aid and I could run first aid on this volume. I'm not going to do it right now because it might take some time and I'm not experiencing any issues, but all you have to do is click run and it will try to find any issues in the file system and repair them for you. Now at the same time, we could erase this volume, but you'll notice that it's grayed out because this is the volume where my home folder is located. So if I created a second installation of Macintosh over here, another volume, I would then be able to erase that volume at some point as well. So to create a second volume, what I would like to do if I was creating a second Macintosh volume, which is essentially a whole nother hard drive, so you know, you might be able to access certain user accounts on this volume, and then the other volume might be for business or something like that. I could go up here to the volume container and I could click on the plus volume button and I could go ahead and start creating my volume by giving it a name. We could call this like volume 2. I can choose the file system format. By default for Macintosh installations, we want APFS. If you don't have a reason to choose one of these other options, just stick with the general APFS one. And then you can go down here to size options. And in here, you can set some size options. The reserve size would be the minimum amount of space that you're going to keep available for this volume. So I could say something like 30 gigabytes. And then the quota size would be the maximum amount of space that we would like to let this volume take up. So we could set the quota to 50 gigabytes. So it will always have at least 30 gigabytes reserved for this volume, and it will not let this volume take up more than 50 gigabytes. So we could click OK, and then if we wanted to add this volume, we could click Add. Now, I'm not going to do that right now. I don't want to change my partitions and volumes on my system, but if as long as you have enough free space, you should absolutely be able to add that volume as simply as that. Now, you'll notice that I also have this partition on the left called Bootcamp, and this is actually my Windows installation that I run on this computer. It runs great. I can do everything that any other Windows user can do. So you'll notice that this volume is the Windows NT file system. So this is a different type of file system than Macintosh HD, which we would need in order to run Windows. So for this particular volume, you'll notice that I can't run first aid because first aid is Mac specific here in disk utility. If I wanted to run some first aid on that volume, I could either use the Bootcamp app or I could go into Windows and see if I could repair it from there. Notice that I could erase this volume, however, because it's not my main Mac installation, so I could erase it, and I could also restore this volume. So if I had saved a copy of this volume as a disk image, I could click on restore, and then I could find the image or the snapshot of a particular hard drive that I would like to restore. Okay, so if you have a backup that you need to restore, this is how you can do it. You can use that restore feature. Now you'll notice that on the left over here, I also have a flash drive connected. So I wanted to show you kind of what that looks like as well. So if I click on the flash drive, you'll notice that this is in a different format. This is in an MS-DOS FAT32 format. So your flash drives can have different formats as well. This is actually a format that should also work on Windows. That's why I like to keep my flash drives in FAT32. So you'll notice that I could go over here and I could click erase to erase this flash drive. And when I do that, it asks me what format I want my flash drive to be in. So by default, if you're just a Mac user, they'll usually put it in macOS Extended. And this will make it so that you can use the flash drive on Mac computers, but if you try and open the files on Windows computer, it's not going to work very well. So that's why I choose the MS-DOS FAT32. So if you have a flash drive that you haven't done anything with, but for some reason you're not able to use it on Windows, you could go in here to Disk Utility and you could click Erase Flash Drive like we just did, and then just make sure you put it in the MS-DOS FAT32 format. I wouldn't change any security options unless you have a particular reason to, and then you can just click Erase and it will reformat that flash drive into the format that you chose. So that is a pretty easy way to do that. Now notice that for all of these drives that we've been looking at, we get to see how much space they've used versus how much free space they have. So this is about a 4 gigabyte flash drive and I've only used about 418 megabytes. For my Windows installation, I've used 800 gigabytes and I still have 200 gigabytes free. So that is a 1 terabyte installation or pretty close to it. You can see up here 993 gigabytes. And then for my Macintosh data, it has 3 terabyte volume, and I've only used 600 gigabytes, so I have plenty of space on this Mac hard drive as well. Notice that you can also disconnect flash drives here in Disk Utility. So if I just clicked on this flash drive, I could unmount it, which is essentially, you know, right-clicking on it here on the desktop and clicking on Eject Flash Matrix. So that's how you can unmount drives as well. I just want to go over one last use case. Let's say you wanted to create a new Windows installation on your computer. And I have these two really volumes right here where I have my Macintosh volume where I have 3 terabytes allocated. I have my bootcamp volume where I have basically 1 terabyte allocated. And I need to create a new volume. Now I'm not going to use my bootcamp volume because you'll notice that I don't have much space. But I do have 2.37 terabytes of free space on this Macintosh HD volume. So what I could do is I could go up here to the top and I could click on the partition button. I'm not going to click on plus volume because notice that it says that's going to add an APFS volume. So that's going to be only for Mac installations. But if I go to partition, now I can actually partition some of this 3 terabyte drive that I have into a new volume, which is amazing. In the old days, you wouldn't be able to do that. Once this drive was already formatted and it had a operating system installed on it, you wouldn't be able to break it down very easily afterwards. But nowadays we can. Notice that from this screen we can select our different drives. But so I want to select the Macintosh HD, and where you see the lines on here, that is space that I've used, and then the clear blue is all free space. So I'm just going to click on the plus button and it asks me, do I want to add a volume or a partition? Well, this is the same thing that we've been talking about. If we just want to add a Mac installation, we could click add volume. But we don't. We want Windows and we need it to be a different file system. So we're going to click add partition. You'll notice that when I do that, the graphic on the left actually already changes to show us what our new partition structure would look like. So we can give this partition a name. We could say this is called like Windows 2. And then for format, we don't want to choose APFS because that's what we'd use for Mac installations. Now notice that we do have these options at the bottom, MS-DOS FAT and Extended FAT. Now you can install older versions of Windows on these file systems, but they aren't best for, say, Windows 10, which uses NTFS. So what we would do is we could choose probably Extended FAT, because then you could have an installation larger than 32 gigabytes. So let's choose Extended FAT. And then we can go over here to the left and we can actually adjust the size. So let's say we only wanted to have it be 1 terabyte. We could get it as close to 1 terabyte as possible, and that will leave us with 2.01 terabytes on the Macintosh installation. We still have our other bootcamp installation. But again, we're not formatting it in NTFS because we can't do that right here in Disk Utility. So what I'm going to do is I would apply this, and then we could go into Bootcamp Assistant and we could reformat this partition to NTFS, but we've already allocated it here in Disk Utility so that we don't have any errors when we go into bootcamp. So for example, let's say I applied this, then what I would do is I would open up Spotlight again like we did earlier in the video, and I would search for Bootcamp Assistant. Go ahead and open that up. And in Bootcamp Assistant, you could kind of read through a little bit and click Continue. And at this point, it's telling me I already have Windows installed. So it's going to format that version of Windows. However, if I didn't have Windows installed, I would be able to partition some of my hard drive to install Windows, and all I have to do is select this partition named Windows 2. It's an extended FAT. It'll reformat it to NTFS, and then I can complete this Bootcamp Assistant process to install Windows on my Mac computer. So that's how you can use disk utility to create different partitions. So hopefully this covered most of the ways that you would use disk utility. Again, real easy to repair volumes by just clicking on them and then going to first aid. You can partition new volumes by using the partition option. And then you can see all of the information about a particular volume or flash drive simply by clicking on it. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.